one, guys, it's Deathmonk here. Today I'm going to be talking about some rather interesting information concerning the future of Fortnite, going from Chapter 4, Season 3, leading into Chapter 5, later this year. So most of these leaks are coming from Fortnite data miners, so let's take a look at what they have to say. So as you guys can see, courtesy of iFileMonkey, now there was an alleged first-person mode. Now, apparently there was, for a short amount of time, a setting in-game where you could actually go into first-person mode. I think you had to go into, like, replay mode, change a setting, come out of replay mode, or I think it was in Save the World, if I'm not mistaken. Go into Save the World, save a setting, come back out to Save the World, go into Battle Royale, and go into Battle Royale in first-person. Now, while he doesn't have much of a major update to share about the mode, he still doesn't know when it'll release. Well, he can say over the season they have been updating sound files to change how weapons sound in first person. Some sound files that have been updated include the ray gun, cloak gauntlets, explosive repeater, mammoth pistol, heavy sniper, Excalibur rifle, kinetic boomerang, DMR, the makeshift revolver, the bandages, eating fish, grappler, medkit, shadow tracker, crossbow, suppressed sniper, standard sniper, pistol, pickaxes, infantry rifle, combat pistol, makeshift pump, Dragon's Breath Sniper, Primal Pistol, and more. Also, as first-person mod has continued to be updated, there have been some bugs with the already existing first-person mod in Save the World, like I said, such as being able to emote and then be a pickaxe ever so slightly in the camera's view. They've also been updating how the camera works when doing stuff such as using weapon sprays, etc, etc. I know this probably isn't that crazy of a news topic, but he's just gotten quite a few questions recently regarding first-person, so I thought he'd share what he already knows. So that's interesting there. I think he went further on to say, minder, back before Chapter 4 Season 2 launched, FireMonkey and G-Matrix Games had leaked a few Battle Royale mechanics that hadn't released yet, and those were legendary augments from combat caches, mutated animals from monster crystals, which is rather interesting, a big attachable wheel grenade, a rope chain launcher. Now, that apparently was found in the in-game files, but for some reason not made it to Battle Royale yet, wall running and wall kicking. Exotic weapons include the Boogie Bomb Grenade Launcher, that sounds a bit OP, Firefly Grenade Launcher, a Gas Grenade Launcher, a Slug Projectile Shotgun, a Balloon Sniper, a Flare Shotgun, a Gas Sniper, and a Rift Pistol. As a bonus, a developer item that never released but was worked on was a Capture Ball, sounds a bit like Pokemon to me, which I can only assume was a test item made to mimic a Pokeball, allowing you to capture animals, but this doesn't mean they were going to collab with Pokemon, just means they had an item that might have had a similar mechanic being worked on before, could be related to that monster crystal. The reason he's bringing these old leaks back is because the timeline is because, as the seasons have gone on, some of the upcoming things leaked back then have still been releasing over time, so as we get closer to the next season, only 25 days remaining or so, he thought why not allow to speculate over what might be added. So that's really interesting there. The racing mode, Delmar, presumably that's what's called in the in-game files, Delmar, is most likely could potentially coming in Chapter 5. Now this is likely Epic's next big permanent mode. It's got a special lobby and a battle pass, a garage menu, a default car similar to the image below, which indicates we may be able to unlock and collect cars in the garage. Now this information is coming from Not Jules Dev, who's a Fortnite data miner, so I'm not exactly sure on his credibility, but these looks really interesting. Now, I would love to see a Lamborghini at some point in the future coming to Fortnite. I'm pretty sure I may have already have, but I think I may have missed it. But that's really interesting there. Spotted by G-Matrix Games a few days ago, it appears the NEF Fortnite merch collab has received new items such as summer guff trucker hats, no sweat summer shirts, and more. So that's currently on NEF headwear, apparently. So that's really interesting there. Now, apparently, according to Not Jules Dev again, there's going to be several racing mode maps for that previous leak I spoke about, Delmar and the racing mode. Apparently there's going to be Apollo, which is going to be a Chapter 2 reference, because the code name that was used to represent the Chapter 2 map was actually Apollo. So we could be heading back to Chapter 2 on that one, but we'll have to wait and see. Cruise, Drift Mania, Facade, Infinity, Jack Rabbit, Olympus, Rally, Sidewinder, Snap, Sweet Jumps, Turbine, and for competitives, Sweet Jumps, a Sand Circuit, Turbine, and Drift Mania EC3. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I think Driftmania, if I'm not mistaken, I think is another video game on console. I'll have to double check on that. I'm fairly sure I've seen that before, or heard that name before at least. But that's really interesting to take note of here, guys. Is there much more I need to tell you guys? October 2023, according to PlayStation Game Size. No, that's nothing to do with Fortnite. Oh, that's right. Jujutsu Kaisen and Fortnite cosmetics from Barbie Harp, who's another data miner apparently. Now, he's found some rather interesting information. So I'm just going to zoom in on this video. Let me know your guys' views and thoughts of this in the comments. So we've got various different skins. I think this is Nobara, I think his name is. Nobara Kugisaki. I'm going to butcher some of these names, I reckon. But they look pretty cool. We've also got Kon, which is the name of a backbling, apparently. But that looks pretty cool. So that's for 600 V-Bucks. We've also got Sweet Selection Backbling. These all look pretty cool, if I do say so myself. Let me know my guys' thoughts of all of these in the comments. Signature Straw Doll, which I'm thinking is representing that epic backbling on the left-hand side of the screen there. This is all coming from Barbie Harper, so a massive shout out to him. Again, let me know what you guys' thoughts and views of this in the comments box down below. Is there much more I need to tell you guys? I don't think there is, but if anyone else. Oh, hang on a minute. Donald Mustard has posted a rather interesting image of what appears to be. Is that like a wood burning on a fire, I think? Or like a little plant pot, if you will, with. Twigs and other pieces of wood and fire, I think that is, and shot down from up above. Let me know what you guys' thoughts and views of this. This could potentially be hinting towards something, but we'll have to wait and see. I did mention a few. I think I may have mentioned this in like a little short video that I made, but I'll see if I can bring that back up for you guys. Now, over this past week or so, there was also a challenge that involves doing the telescope. Now, if you take over all those little pieces that are scattered around the map and take them to one of the NPCs in the center of the map, you will notice on the roof of that building there is a telescope under construction. So it appears once the telescope is fully built, it will be watching an astral map in the stars. There's also a file relating to four stages of a rift, gate, and sky tear that will continue to progress throughout the rest of the season. Now, this is not currently in-game at this present moment in time, however, it is in the in-game files. So as you guys can see, it says tooltip, rift gate, and sky tear progression states. The blueprint tried saying true, so we know it's going to happen at some point. I just don't know why it's not appearing in my games at the moment, but just to give you a bit of an idea what this actually is going to look like. Now, courtesy of AEP Tax on Twitter, this is who this video is coming from. So as you guys can see, this is what we're going to expect to see some point in the map. Now, you will notice there's this little pink laser. Now, from what I understand, this pink laser could potentially be used by the telescope, which is currently in the map at the moment, and we're going to expect to see something like this form in the sky as a result of it. So that looks really interesting there. So as you guys can see, there's a telescope that's on top of the building right there. That's the laser that's coming out of it somehow or other, and that's what we're going to expect to see at some point in the map. Now, like I say, guys, it's not currently in game now. But once it does, I'll let you guys know. Make sure you guys stay tuned to the channel. If you're new to the channel, please smash the subscribe button. Don't forget notification bells to see more videos. And just to quickly finish this off, there's the alleged leak for Jujutsu Kaisen. And let me know what your guys' thoughts are. Like and subscribe, hit the notification bell. Make sure you guys use my support code on the item shop, DeathMonk992. Just disappear after every 2 weeks. Make sure you guys keep putting it back in. I'll see you in the next one. Until then.